What's happening, folks?
The boys are back.
Oh, the boys are back in town. We're all fired up for this episode, folks. That's right.
That's right, dudes. Look what just got dropped today.
Oh, new beer release.
Oh. Ooh,
hazy.
The big hazy. We were talking hazy. About this.
Yeah, it is funny, though.
This is the brainchild of Steve over here. Is yeah, like, you know, is. We need a hazy IPA for
Kevin Hayes.
For big Kevin yeah. Hayes. And the last brewery I thought that would do it was the Yards, to be honest.
I know.
They're just so traditional and your hair looks whatever. And they're like, we only make ales and all that stuff, and pale ales and IPAs fit into that. That's why they make Cape of Good Hope.
Yeah,
and,
I can't say I'm excited that they're the ones IPA. That did the hazy double NEIPA because you know they're not known for that style.
I know.
Obviously,
got a lot of.
And not like this is like a crazy brainstorm. I'm sure a million people thought about the haze, you know. But it's cool that they did it.
I thought maybe Broken Goblet or you know they did a lot of Eagles beers. They did a Bryce Harper beer right away.
Right.
There's been tons of Eagles beers. Obviously, I think Imprint had one and Stable 12, and you can go back through our Facebook page and see that post. There was one with.
It's nice to see a Flyers beer again, though. I think it's the first one since Ghost Bear, maybe from old
that
Conchi.
I can think of. Yeah, which
maybe.
Was
yeah.
you know kind of a more
poor Giroux. Moderate. Poor Giroux has never gotten one, but you know it's all right.
There's, yeah, well, time. You know it's funny because Glenn McNamara wrote an article all about Claude Giroux and the kind of not really so much about the lack
I
of
saw
respect
that.
He's got,
yeah,
but
yeah.
it was in there. But he basically said it's going to take him.
Jesus,
and,
when did you get my hair
and,
to be plumed? Like
yeah,
the hair is looking good on
it's
yours,
like Ric
dude.
Like Ric Flair wigs.
I know.
It's
Woo!
Like him and Kata Hot got to take us to the promised land. So hopefully that happens.
Yeah.
But
we heard about this dropping, and like it's funny. I mean, seriously, literally like a couple days ago, last time we were together, and we were like, "There's got to be a Kevin
it was
Hazy
like Wednesday or whatever."
You know,
and then,
there's got to be a Kevin Hazy IPA. Make it a hazy IPA. If it's not a hazy IPA, it's just a fail.
Right.
And so I got to give Yards props just for coming up with it. I mean, not that it's easy to, hard to come up with, but at least they did it, you know?
Right. Probably a long time coming.
But these guys have been doing a lot of sports stuff. They did the Connor Barwin beer he just did with
them.
They
did. And they all had the first beer for the Philadelphia Union, right?
Yeah. And I will say, we've been Yards fans for, I mean, Brawler was one of our first loves in the malty beer
Absolutely.
Scene.
Absolutely.
It's a great beer. And I don't think we've ever reviewed a Yards beer. So, I mean, it's a Philly thing. We're Philly guys. And
it's... Man, if we did, we didn't air it.
Yeah. But these guys are kind of like Yangling and kind of some of these other old school brewers, so they really don't deviate from what they do, you know? And they're just,
no,
and
they're
if they
really
try a new
good.
Style, it's usually not done that great, so I'm not, you know.
Yeah, I mean, their foray into sours and everything to me was like a total failure. I mean,
people like that pink one, but I'm
they
not
do.
A big fan
I'm
of that.
Not a big
I'm
fan
not, but,
of
you know, but anyway, but I do like the company. I do like, I've been there. It was one of the first breweries
yeah,
I ever toured, actually.
It's the same here.
It's kind of a Philly institution, and they're growing, and they're getting bigger, and I thought they would kind of just jump with the times and do some of the kind of crazy. Not everything has to be a hazy IPA, but I thought they would kind of just launch into like at least some of that. And they really have kind of really just stuck true to their roots. I mean, their last IPA in this series, the first draft was a Spruce Tips IPA, and it was just oh my god, it was rough. I got that for these guys for Christmas for Mark and my sister, and it was
hard no on that one.
Yeah, it was weird. It was weird. Anyway,
so I think the biggest test of this one first is going to be appearance.
Yeah, now, they said it's going to be like an orange, Flyers orange, so I guess they're already making excuses for why it's not going to be hazy.
Why it's not like a yellow,
it's going to be more like
looking.
A why it's going to be more like an orange type
it
of amber beer.
It is.
Right. Yeah, so the haze factor is not going to be there, which I didn't expect
no,
anyway.
It doesn't
but,
look like those lactose
yeah, you get a
hazes
juice there.
You're going to get.
A little high on the old head.
I mean, it's...
It smells
it's
okay.
It's definitely not your typical New England looking hazy, but that's what we expected. So far... This is, I guess, meeting expectations, but I've lowered the bar for these guys just because I didn't expect.
Yeah, I don't know. This is what
really
you consider hazy.
Yellow.
This is like a ruby. It's, I mean, it's cloudy. It's unfiltered, but it's nothing like, you know. This looks exactly like the beer that I saw when I went on Tapped. I kept trying to go on Untapped and check and see where it was, and all they have is Big Hazy. See, they had a beer before this called Big Hazy, not even that far before. People were checking into it like last month. And till now, and it was just called Big Hazy, regular Big Hazy. And I think what they did is they just took this from the brewery, like, shit, we got this, we're gonna can it, we're gonna do a Kevin Hayes
right,
thing.
We're gonna do a little marketing going.
So we're not doing anything special, we're just gonna give you the crap that we gave you before and just can it and do whatever. So, which is cool, but, you know, to me it seems a little shortcutty and a little unthought of.
Yeah, this is part of their first draft small batch series. We're starting to see this, too, from We had that Heavy Seas beer a couple episodes ago, and they've done the same thing where they've kind of, they have like a small like offshoot side project like a band would have,
right.
where they're just doing like smaller batch stuff, testing it within their own market, and if it makes it good enough to can it, you know, so be it. If it doesn't, you know, no harm done.
I will say the nose is like a candied, it's very candied. It's like a candied tropical sweet tart almost kind of.
Big nose on this one. Big Brad Marchand on
it
this
is.
One.
It is. And you know what? It's really, and we had Desert Fog and some other really good Albuquerque beers before this because my cousin did another care package.
And we had to probably warm up. You know,
but this is not bad.
A warm up.
This is not bad at all. It's pretty tasty, honestly. It's very like strong artificial orange almost. It's like a candied orange kind of, you know, it tastes like I'm, for me, I feel like I'm eating like a sweet tart, like an orange sweet tart or something. You know, I'm getting that a lot. And it's not super, super sweet, but maybe that's just my palate adjusting from the last beer. It's got a bit of that dry yards kind of
it's
bitter
dry,
finish
hoppy,
to it.
Bitter.
It's not, yeah.
It's
you know?
Got all that, which we expected.
Yeah.
The fruit, I would agree, it's not a smooth melon taste. It's a very...
It's powdery. It's like powdered, you know?
Yeah, it's very hop citrus type of deal.
Not bad, though. I mean, I would...
Candy, like Steve said, like kind of orange peel. Definitely orange zest.
Yeah, maybe that kind of, yeah. But for some reason, taste. I'm getting like a candy... just like if I ate too many sprees or something like that, my throat's sort of getting all dry.
Eating junk food all day.
No. I'm doing good. Look at this. Trim. Fit as a fit, man. Ab test. No. Mark and I are both incidentally been on a bit of a low carb diet.
Thanks for the kind words.
That's right. That's right.
Appreciate
We've actually had to zoom in more because our bodies aren't taking up as much of the screen as they used to, and that's just, you know.
Right. You're gonna. Yeah,
it's just nature. It's just nature saying we're doing a good job. No, I'm still fat as shit.
Woo!
But,
Mohawk hats. In the hizzy.
I know. Look at the wind blowing.
Let's go. Let's go.
Anyway, but no, we've been on a bit of a, so the beer reviews are coming kind of few and far between, and sometimes just because we'll be damned if we're going to go drink seltzers just because that's what's going to be better for
right.
you. I don't care. You
right.
know, we got to drink this fat stuff, but you know, you drink this crap, you just have to work hard.
Maybe there's
going to
be some lower carb reviews coming up for the people. It looked like we got a pretty good response to my post about low carb beers.
Mm-hmm.
So I think everybody's kind of mentally aware if their liver isn't aware yet, maybe it soon will be, but.
I think as technology improves, I think they're going to be able to find something that can... It's hard to replicate for me the hop profile, the mouthfeel, and all the real intense flavors when you do that really super low-carb stuff. But I think once they become... Once somebody figures out how to do it... I mean, Christ, I never knew they were... I never thought they were going to have lactose and IPAs and the milkshake IPA movement.
Right,
off,
right.
So.
It's a little reverse...
If they can do that kind of stuff, you know... I know. Thank you for making me super fat and now having to try to work my way back against the tide. But anyway, this is a you know what this is a win for me. I like this beer.
It is.
I don't hate it. But
don't
you know,
hate it.
And I don't want to hate on Yards because I like Yards. I like the guys. It's
I want
cool
like
crew. I like the
I
people
do.
A lot. And
it's
a really good beer.
Guys,
I wouldn't call this like a malt bomb. Like you're not going to diss this.
Not
it's not like
bomb.
A drain pour type of deal. You know,
definitely not.
It's kind of what I expected, but actually, this is better than what I expected. And it's good. I could drink this watching the Flyers. Like it tastes like orange, and I think that's the whole thing.
We intend to do that.
What I like about it is I think that they wanted to give it like an orange hue. They wanted to make it taste kind of orangey, and I think they made it like a tropical orange kind of drink. You know?
Yeah, they hit the
mark. It's almost like a, not an orange Gatorade or an orange Kool-Aid, but it's definitely got an intense.
Yeah, I mean, this is a score. This isn't top shelf, you know, corner off the post, but it's a goal. It's a quality goal scorer's goal.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Top shelf. Maybe not. It's a five hole.
It's not a highlight reel, but
it's one that like bounced right underneath the arm. It's one of those. It's like not a total hit, not a total miss. It's just
hole.
Like you know, it might be a Lawton deflection. I don't know.
How about Bobby Ryan deflection the other night?
Yeah. Sweet. Shout out to Bobby Ryan for coming back and
he had
a hat trick.
Native,
you know,
had a hat trick in his first game back.
Some guy the Flyers wanted for years and years and years, and thank God they kind of passed on. I don't think he
a guy that
here,
is
but...
a big fan of ours.
Yeah.
You know, he's a big drinker, and he's working on that. And we're glad to see that he's doing better and he's back.
He can do both,
and he's having a great impact. So
hopefully
cheers,
you know, he scores 20 more goals and has like 20 beers.
I was still hopeful he'd be a Flyer one day, and I still am.
Yeah.
You know. Issues be damned.
Who knows?
But so yeah, we'll talk a little bit. Did you want to get into something else? I want to talk a little hockey.
I was getting into Kevin Hayes, and you know just how much I'm really happy that, you know, when Hayes first came on the scene, as far as this is like from my worldview of the hockey view, it's like they got him. And originally I thought, like, oh, this is an overpay. Like, this guy's a 25 goal scorer, right. 20 goal scorer.
We knew Hayes. We've seen Hayes.
Is he going to be that guy's going to take the next leap? Is he just going to give you what he got? Is he going to go through the motions? So is that like, there's like $7 million a year? Okay, whatever. And then when the story started to come out where he was like, I don't know why Philly did this, and it was a really it wasn't even like
through the media, but not like
it gave you the feeling like by
his own doing, really.
Yeah.
If those things were true, and it was something that he said probably in confidence.
He
to
said they
else,
weren't though. That guy later, he retracted media. His words and stuff. He said that's not really what I meant. Whatever, but
it's possible.
But at first, so you're thinking like, all right, Fletcher overpaid for this guy. Now he doesn't even want to be here. And people are like, oh, this guy's going to be. And Flyer cynics that we all are, you know, you always get this guy. I think it's going to be maybe the next big splash because we're kind of spoiled. I think Flyers fans, like in our era that grew up, are always waiting for that next John LeClair. Like, you know, we're going to sign this guy and he's going to be a diamond in the rough. He's going to come out and he's going to score 50 goals instead of 20 goals or do something amazing. But I really think that in today's modern game, and you can't expect a whole lot from these guys as far as
Johnny Clair was a fourth line, third line center that we saw in Montreal playing against the Kings in the 93 playoffs.
Right.
And he was like a man on fire, but he was still, you know, a bottom six step forward. And when we got him, I wouldn't say he's a throw in on that deal, but.
Yeah, Desjardins was kind of the main.
He went and, it was Recchi for what? Desjardins and him. Yeah. And even there was another guy, Gervais.
Oh, I forget.
Or somebody in there that didn't even end up being a Flyer for the next year. But yeah, that's not going to happen a lot.
Yeah, but what for Hayes gives you on the penalty kill, first of all, he's just a stud. He's
a beast on the puck.
He's great with that stick. He's great carrying the puck. He has that kind of poise. I think we had one more player like that. Like, I wish, like, Voracek used to have that kind of ability. Now that he skates in, he seems so reckless that he loses the puck a whole lot. I think if he held on and used his body a little bit more like Hayes does. Like, Hayes doesn't even panic. He just kind of, like, he doesn't skate the super fast, but he does have a nice burst when he has to.
Yeah, Voracek could learn a little bit about making
but
the pass
that's
there.
Yeah, he can fend guys off and just, you know. The other thing, too, is, like, Hayes, when he has the chances, he's scoring. Like, you see Farabee, like, just for an example, not to pick on the rookie, but they measure up shots. Even Giroux all year long, they've been measuring up, and they wait, and they finally shoot and miss.
He had one the other day, a one-timer from Provorov could have been in the net, and he waited and waited.
Yeah,
and waited
they just wait, and, like, the more the Flyers measure up these shots, the worse they are. Hayes takes that pass from Lawton the other night, like way back behind him, but he has the hockey knowledge that, like, Cowan and I were talking about, the street hockey knowledge, like just his presence just to deal with whatever, like whatever comes out, you just make something out of
he
it.
Made he made that great, like, one-timer shot off kind of like a rebound, like a missed slap shot, but like they were showing his game against the Rangers where, again, he caught the pass really behind him, but it's in his wheelhouse.
Right, exactly.
He can start that shot motion.
Right.
It's not as quick as a snap as you'd see from other players, but
it's
going to
be enough to fool
you
because you don't know when the release is going to come either, you know?
And if you go and cross the net, which he did on Lundqvist that one time, he can bury him.
Yeah.
He gets knocked on his skating and speed a bit, but I'll tell you what. Yeah. Look at the breakaways he scores on the penalty kill.
Exactly.
Given it's not like a straight race because you got guys coming this way and he's kind of going that way.
Remember when Giroux?
They have to turn around and adjust, but
so
he doesn't have that breakout speed.
No,
but speed.
Then
he's got
the
got
body
enough.
Positioning and he has the stick length to just fend
that's
them off
the
if they do
he's
catch
got
up
enough
to him too.
That, right. Nice. Even if they kind of are on his trails, he'll get a shot.
I mean, when's the last time you saw Giroux have breakaways galore? He used to be a breakaway guy like all the time.
Well, when,
you know?
When do you see him ever not get the shot or not get a chance?
I think there's one thing I'd like to see tonight.
Whenever he's on that break, he gets a scoring chance.
I'd like to see a little more stretch passing from the Flyers too. I think they can do it in today's day and age. I think there's no reason why you can't. I'd like to see a little more, you know, blue line to blue line stuff.
A little bit about, I think, why we don't see that as much as we used to.
Vigneault style
is it's five attack, five defend. You don't get that separation as much for those stretch passes.
Yeah.
Where you got, and I want to say guys are cherry
it's
picking.
It's good style
but
though. It's not a super aggressive forecheck either though.
Not super aggressive, but it's like it's aggressive in the sense that it's just tighter gaps.
Yeah, more on the puck carry versus
the lines.
Like, it's not so much going into the offensive zone and just raising hell, but it's more just like keeping everybody responsible.
Yeah,
you know,
and
space.
And then when we get those chances, we kind of have everybody, and you see this a lot. It's not even just the offensive minded defense when we have, it's just the position that we have. There's a quick transition, and oftentimes you see Sanheim, you see Myers, all they're ready to jump in.
And you know, and honestly,
Braun,
I mean,
not so much
it's hard to believe.
Style, but.
It's hard to believe that our defensive contributions have been so great. Like, we're like third in the league now in defensive goals scored, which is like hard to believe.
Provorov lead.
And that's
lead.
Without Ghost even really doing anything this year. He's got five goals. I mean, imagine if he was like clicking on all cylinders, you know?
Yeah, you got Provy's got seven power play goals, which leads the league. The big thing, and I was telling it's people,
good. I think if they were just a little stronger on the puck, they'd be a better team. I think if Vigneault gets some guys that are really good, I think the one thing, the weakness we have is that we lose a lot of those one-on-one battles along the boards. We lose a lot of those, you know, a lot of teams, they come in and just have a stronger stick and they just fight us off the puck.
And I don't
or they beat us up in front of our own net every now and then, but we've been a lot better in front of our own net than we have been in the last couple of years.
I don't want to diss on Farabee either here, but, you know, he makes himself an easy defendable target at times.
He'll be fine. Because he just turned 20 the other day.
He plays very peripherally. Yeah. He tries to play in space, but when that space gets taken away, he's easily rubbed out. Yeah. And he's one that makes a very...
He'll be fine. I'm not worried about him.
Yeah, he makes a lot of low percentage passes back into the crease, cross crease stuff. And it ends up just being a giveaway. That's something he'll learn, you know, as time comes on. But in space, there's nobody I'd rather have than Konechny and Farabee on a 2-on-1.
Exactly.
Like any pair with one of those two plus
Farabee
somebody else.
Has that.
Even Michael Raffle.
I really think it's a shame. I think if Lindblom was still around and if Patrick was healthy, Patrick's the kind of guy I think that would really play well with a guy like Farabee because they have those kind of creative instincts where, like,
very nifty.
A lot of times Farabee makes this kind of crazy wild pass and, like, nobody's ready for it. And it's just like, God, you idiots. Just be ready for his, like, and that happened with Patrick a lot last year where, like, Patrick would make these almost, like, just amazing, almost like a Gretzky-esque type pass where, like, he was behind the net, just no look, throw up behind. And the stupid idiots he was on his line with were just like, you know,
oblivious to what's going on. Yeah.
I will say Lawton's really picked that up pretty nice.
Lawton's been great.
But you look at the...
apparently his name came up a lot as being wanted via trade. Yeah. That was apparently not in Fletcher's plan, so it didn't happen. But there was a lot of suitors, you know, asking for Lawton's services. And I'm glad to see him stay. They still got him under contract for a couple
funny.
Years.
Yeah, it's funny. I mean, he and Kutz have really kind of finally... And it's funny, that's the other thing.
That's that core of
you look at people
picks.
Like people online talking about Frost and Farabee, like, oh, send them down, they're not ready yet. Well, you know what? We had Lawton miss like 4 or 5 camps in a row, and now he's finally like a 12-goal scorer. You know, and like even Couturier is finally
a
30-goal
scorer. That was in the juniors, Canada team captain.
Yeah, right, exactly.
I mean, this is the guys that had the pedigree of your Mike Richards. I know he didn't work out the way we all would have hoped. Or Jeff Carter. You know, guys
if
Canada hockey loves
kids.
You, like, you're doing something right.
Right.
You know, Couturier's kind of had that pedigree. You know, I think Lawton had that pedigree. Giroux certainly had that pedigree coming in.
Mm-hmm.
But he, of the two, was
Carter Hart's got that pedigree.
More of the
Kata-ha.
Less two-way and more of just the offensive-minded guy. So,
yeah.
And we know how the Flyers draft. They love their two-way guys. They love their gritty centers and their power forwards. And, you know, so that's what we end up with. But
yeah, they get a little too center-happy sometimes, and they just worry about that. But
and I was a little worried about even our recent acquisitions.
Well,
again, we're, like, really building up on this. I know they're kind of rental players.
Right,
not
and they're
really,
just kind of...
We're not in debt to them and the contract-wise, but...
Yeah, in my mind, it was the Flyers not having faith in the young kids. Let's send them down, get them more seasoning. We're probably going to make the playoffs, and we're looking good, so let's get some veteran guys in here who can handle that kind of play.
Safe move.
Yeah, it was very safe. Yeah. I like Thompson's play. I wasn't really blown away by Grant at all. He had a bad penalty. He would look really slow out there compared to the rest of the Flyers. I'm like, whoa, dude, you got to pick it up.
Yeah.
He looks very stout. He looks really, like, if you look at him, when you watch him skate tonight, he looks fat in his jersey. You see the guy? He almost looks like he's out of shape, but that's just me. Not that I can talk.
I'm calling you out, Grant.
Yeah, no, but he just, you know, hopefully has, I mean, he's got 14 goals this year, which is cool. But, I mean, I wasn't sold on his aggressiveness at all. He didn't do, like, one good thing that last game. Not one good thing that I saw. But they didn't play him a whole lot either because the fourth line's playing so much better than that so-called third line. It's weird. The Flyers have, like, the first line, which is Giroux and Kutz.
Which you can't deny now.
Good.
With
but
G and
the second
Kutz
line,
and Jake,
the second line, the second line of Hayes and Lawton and Konechny are, like, your first line. They're playing better than the first line is, really. So, that's your first line.
That's
and
been
like,
happening for
the
years.
The first line's your second line.
Sorry
the fourth
to say
line,
our boy club. But
the fourth line is, like, your third line, and the third line was playing, like, they're getting fourth line minutes because JVR can slack off any given night. You know, he always likes to – he's kind of hot and cold.
Yeah, but the acquisitions, you know? I still almost count him more of a this-year guy. Mm-hmm. I almost forget about last year because it was such a waste of a year. But
yeah, he got hot though. He always gets hot at the end of the year.
We'll see. He's not a bad guy to have on the team.
He needs to perfect. He needs to perfect that between the legs move though from the side of the net because these guys are scoring like crazy. You see Willie Nylander's the other night.
Yeah,
it was effortless. But JVR does it. He always like kind of throws it right in the goalie's pads. So anyway, it's getting on 20 minutes here.
Looking at our clock here.
It's a 20-minute period.
Welcome to the first period.
What did you say? This is like the Spies Like Us gear. We broke out the old Mohawk hats from, these hats were like from like 20 years ago.
Yeah,
right
I got this
maybe?
From a GLG 20.
These are old. These are Reeboks.
These are old. These are Christmas 2000 and
who knows.
Shit, I don't know.
I love it though.
We still got them. We love them.
Yeah. All right, kids. Anyway, this is our special Kevin Hayes. I still love your hair is so much better than mine. Look at the
I do have a better fluff. I got like a Farrah Fawcett.
I know you do. You're totally Farrah Fawcett. Broad Street Boys. I'm getting there now. I'm more like a Luke.
You gotta tease them.
I'm like an Owen Wilson right now.
Like mine's been unfettered.
Yeah.
Apparently wherever it's been.
Now I'm gonna start looking like Tomato 11 from
Tomato. Hey, welcome back to those guys too.
Son of Urchin. If you guys want to check out a cool band.
They're
gonna
be doing a show for the first time in 4 years. Reverend BL, who's a guitar tech for Ween, amazing guitar player. They got some other new members playing bass and filling in on rhythm guitar. And they're coming back. They're going to do Philly. I intend to go there, so nice. Stay tuned for that one.
Yeah.
Also, a big shout-out to Big E, Eric Lindros.
Happy birthday, big guy.
Happy birthday, bud. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being such a big fan.
I was drunk one night and I contacted his agent. This is a true story. It was like 3 months ago. So I was like shit faced. I was trying to think about like different things to do, and I was just drunk off my ass. And I was like, I want to do a podcast, like a real podcast. Like, I'm gonna get real people. Like I'm gonna, you know. So I sent him. I sent. It was like content. You know, if you ever go to like a band's website or you go to like a guy's website, just contact us, and it's like goes to his agent or whatever. I'm like, so I sent him emails like, hey, I'm starting blah 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 a new thing. I'd love to have Eric as a guest. Blah blah blah. It was like ridiculous. It was really well written, but it was a mess.
It's a long shot. But
so I was like, whatever. But then like 3 weeks later, the guy's like, sorry. Well, he got back to me right away. He was like, sorry, we're not going to take requests. I'm like, whatever. But then like. Then, like a month later, he was like, hey, are you still interested? Or is there something? Yeah, and I was just like, nah, I was too embarrassed.
We dissed him. Oh, well, there you go.
What's he going to do? Like, Lindros is going to show up on my porch and be like, hey, welcome to Porch Hockey.
We just do it online. We got a little Skype going.
I think with the advent of, like, Spittin' Chiclets and stuff like that, I think it's becoming, like, the hockey
it's
podcast.
It's a more respected outlet.
Yeah, it's becoming kind of popular.
People have actually asked us to podcast this. That might happen one day.
We're more of the visual
creative side.
Yeah. I think I said something. I'm going to ask you the hard hitting questions. Like, I want to get involved. I want to get into like the whole Clark thing back then. I want to get into like the whole like.
Yeah, that probably steered him away.
Not even so much about that, but just honestly, I want to get to know people too. Like, see what he's all about and stuff, and what you know. Like, you very, very rarely get to see. I don't know. I have all kinds of questions for the guy.
One more quick shout out, Peter Laviolette. Congratulations, being named Team USA's coach. Today,
Lavi Davi.
Laviolette was a Flyers coach, as all the Flyers fans watching know, and really became the victim of just poor playoff performances and goaltending carousel. That in hindsight, probably
he did a lot with what he had. No,
we had Bobrovsky had no experience.
I mean, for Christ's sake, we had Leighton in the goddamn freaking Stanley Cup finals. Layton I mean, come and, on, and like, you expect us to win.
Yeah, it was tough.
Of course we're going to lose on a bad goal. What
tough
are you going to do?
A victim of the goalie carousel of Philadelphia.
And over the hill Pronger got exposed on many
Yeah,
many
got injured, and I mean, he had to deal with a lot of hardships. I know he wasn't probably the most favorite of coaches, but I thought he got kind of a raw deal. Same with Barber.
Raw deal.
Same with Berube. But, hey, we love AV, and at least I do. And
I do.
Anyway,
he's great.
Good luck,
great.
Peter. Good luck, Team USA.
That's right.
We love you.
Party on, dudes. You. Now we're going to fight. You still got that tie down one? Is it working?
Mm. I'm not tied in at all.
We both have tie downs. We had no pants on.
I got
down
the C. There. He's got the A.
You got to tie it down to your belt. Look at this. I like this jersey, though. I used to hate it, but you know what? It's coming around on me.
Thank you, Steve Rogers.
Nice Hook work, Stevie.
Jersey. Beauty.
All right, dudes. Dudettes.
And with that, we out of here. We're going to go watch the game. Go Flyers. Kick the Rangers ass.
That's right. Home and home. Big time.
Big games. We could go to the second place here tonight.
All right, we're getting on a half hour here. Look at that. Now you're getting hair in my beer. You're getting mohawk hair in my beer.
Later.